Relatively easy question, a very interesting question, but watch out. Some of these questions could play tricks on your mind, especially when you're solving it. Let's get around to solving it. I would classify it as a 650 level question. How many of the numbers x, y, and z are positive? If each of these numbers is less than 10, so that's a crucial information from the stem, we need to determine how many of x, y, and z are positive. Before we look into the statements, let's get an idea about how the answer should be. This question is asking how many of these x, y, and z are positive. So we need to come up with an answer which is saying two of these numbers are positive. Or we can say none of these numbers are positive. Or we can say all of these numbers are positive. So you need to come up with a number for the number of these numbers which are positive. When is it sufficient? Again, the operative word is basically unique. If you're able to come up with a unique answer, if you're able to say none of these numbers is positive, or if you're able to say all of these numbers are positive, it's absolutely fine. When is it not sufficient? It is not sufficient when you're saying two of these numbers could be positive or it could be three. I'm not sure. That is when the data is not sufficient, right? Now that we have this perspective, let's get into the statements. Statement one, x plus y plus z is equal to 20. From the stem, we know that each of these numbers is less than 10. Let's write this entire information as an inequality. We'll have something as this. X is less than 10, y is less than 10, and z is less than 10. Statement 1 tells us that the sum of these three numbers is equal to 20. Let's get started. Let's just pick some two out of these three numbers. Let's say I'm picking x and y. How high can the sum of x and y be? I'm asking you to find out the maximum possible value for x plus y, given this information that both x and y are less than 10. Both these numbers can inch towards a 10, but can never be a 10. So the maximum possible sum for x and y will still be a number which is less than 20, because x is less than 10, y is less than 10. Sum of these two numbers can never be more than 20, cannot even be a 20. So max possible sum for x and y is less than 20. And this maximum sum is going to happen when we maximize both x and y, which essentially boils down to the fact that points to the information that both x and y will have to be positive, which is when we'll be maximizing the sum. Even at the instance when you have maximized it, we realize that the sum is less than 20 for these two numbers. If the sum of x, y, and z together is equal to 20, and we realize that this number is definitely less than 20, the sum of x and y, to get to a 20, z should have been a positive number to make that happen. We arrived at this max number only when both x and y are positive. So that is a given. X and y are certainly positive. For the sum to be a 20, we realize that z should also contribute something positively, which means z is also positive. So if x, y, and z are all less than 10, and the sum of these three numbers is equal to 20, that's possible only when all three numbers are positive. So from statement 1, I have a unique value for the number of these numbers which are positive. So 1 alone is sufficient. Answer choices are down to A or D. Quickly sum it up in a printed form, the next slide. This is the information that we have from the question stem. This is the information from statement 1. Let's pick some two numbers out of these, taking x and y. The max sum for x and y will be a number less than 20, because each of x and y is less than 10. The sum of these three numbers is equal to 20. That cannot happen without z contributing positively to it. The max sum for x and y itself will be this number less than 20 only when x and y are maximized. So it's evident that x and y are positive to start with. Z is also positive is something we have concluded subsequently, which means that all of these three numbers are positive. We have a unique answer from statement 1. 1 alone is sufficient, rule out choices B, C, E. We are down to A or D. Let's evaluate statement 2 alone to decide whether it is A or D. Statement 2 tells us that x plus y is equal to 14. So two numbers, x and y, add up to a 14. We know that each of these numbers is less than a 10. It's quite evident that both x and y will have to be positive for this to be possible. Just go with a converse logic. Let's say x is a negative number. Let's see whether it is possible. I'm taking x to be a minus 3. So what should y be? Y should be a number greater than 14. Y should become a 17 for the sum to end up becoming a 14. But we know that each of these numbers is less than 10. So y can never take a number which is 10 or even more than 10. Not even a 10 is possible. Which means that you cannot have any negative numbers possible for x. X will also have to be positive. Y will also have to be positive. So from statement 2 till now, we have inferred x and y are positive. Two of these numbers are positive. The only thing left to determine is whether z is also positive. If, for example, x plus y plus z is equal to an 18, sum of these two numbers is a 14, z will also be a positive number. So all three will be positive. This is what we would have got. This is example that we have. Let's look at a counterexample. We do not know what is the sum of x, y, and z. X plus y plus z could very well be a 12. X plus y is a 14. Statement 2 tells us. If the sum is a 12 for all three numbers, then z is going to be a negative number. So minus 2. In that case, how many of these numbers are positive? Two of these numbers are positive. So we are getting more than one answer. How many of these numbers are positive? It could either be 2 or 3. From statement 2, we are not having a unique answer. So 2 alone is not sufficient. The end of statement 1, our answer choices were down to A or D. If 2 is not sufficient, rule out D, we are down to A. A is the answer to the question. Quickly sum it up in a printed form as always. As each of x and y is less than 10, the sum cannot be 14 unless both x and y are positive. That's what we did with an example in the last slide. So we know two of these numbers are definitely positive, but we do not know anything about z. Z could be positive, z could be a 0, z could be negative. All three possibilities exist. So they'll end up with an answer which will say either 2 or 3 of these numbers are positive, which means you're not having a unique value for the number of numbers that are positive from statement 2. 2 alone is not sufficient. If we're down to A or D, rule out D, our answer is A. Choice A is the answer to this question.